Hi, we are Scar Robotics, a division of Student Space Association from Warsaw University of Technology. We are a team consisting mostly of undergraduate students coming from various faculties. This year, we present to you a Sirius 2 rover.
Our team consists of 26 students from various fields, including, but not limited to, aerospace engineering, photonics, chemistry, electronics, mechatronics, and IT. During the last years, we have been testing different team structures. Lately, we created a division of work between 8 subteams. Interface, manipulator, mobile platform, communication, autonomy, wheels and suspension, science, and drone, where each task is split up to most basic assignments. This system allows us to facilitate division of labor, as well as helps coordinators track the progress and solve any problems on the levels they occur. Such division has proven itself as the efficient way to achieve fast and reliable results. The main goal of the Student Space Association is gaining and exchanging knowledge. The best way to achieve this is taking part in various challenges, such as the European Rover Challenge. Our Sirius rover is the second rover in our program and has been in active development over the last 4 years, as a successor of the first iteration. We have implemented and are working on many new solutions that results in constant improvement of the rover, as well as allows us to gain new, valuable experience in engineering and science. In addition, by participating in ERC, we can promote our university, our association, and the space industry overall. This in turn will help us increase the number of engineers in future generations.
Our new control interface is a website built with Vue.js, hosted on the main computer of the rover. It is centered around a modular drag-and-drop window system, which allows for great flexibility and expandability. This solution gives us very robust control over the rover and allows us to visualize its state. Thanks to a new camera backend, which uses WebRTC, we are able to simultaneously stream video from multiple cameras with automatic compression quality selection. The autonomous navigation system facilitates ORB SLAM 3 for visual odometry and occupancy map construction. SLAM data is fused with multiple other sources, such as RUCO, attack detection, GNSS module, and an IMU, to ensure that the system is resistant to drift and tracking loss.
New ideas and solutions are based on the team's experience during previous events and numerous tests performed throughout the years. The new suspension is the subject of the article at the IEEE Aerospace Conference. New experimental copper beryllium suspension has been developed using FEM optimization. To suit its needs, a new transmission system was created. After months of prototyping, field tests, and debates over designs, we have developed wheels that perform well in challenging conditions. They allow us to traverse slopes, rocky and sandy terrains in dry and wet environments.
A newly implemented inverse kinematic solver and trajectory planner for the manipulator allows for precise, gentle movements of the end effector. The closed-loop control, along with a redesigned gripper, allows for the effective manipulation of various tools or lifting objects weighing up to 5 kg. The arm can pick items from the ground in front of the rover, as well as reach heights over 1.5 meters. To ensure safety of operations, we have implemented multiple safety systems in our rover. The motors were selected in such a way that even with maximum available output voltage supplied to them, the rover has no possibility to move faster than 1 meter per second. In case of a loss of communication for a substantial amount of time, the rover will autonomously stop. Furthermore, an emergency button was mounted to the side of the rover. In case of malfunction, pressing it will cut off all power, resulting in an instantaneous stop.
Thank you.
We are continuously redesigning and improving our science module. In the past years, we have successfully developed methods of collecting and analyzing ground samples. Currently, we are working on detecting ice and water underground based on infrared cameras. It is most important for future Mars missions because discovering such deposits could potentially provide landing site with water, rocket fuel, oxidizer, and oxygen, essential to carry out manned missions. We are also considering using Geiger meter to check ground radiation in the area. It will provide information whereas manned missions to the region should be equipped with additional safety measures.